Hey.
How long have you had that hoodie?
This? Oh gosh, 2012, so 8 years. Still in pretty good shape.
Considering how much you wear it.
You think I wear it too much?
I don't know.
Oh gosh. Maybe I do wear this too much. I kind of wear this all the time, don't I? All right, I'm glad you brought it up. I'm gonna give this thing a break. Whole new me.
Yep.
Hey, listen.
Dad, I don't wanna talk about Cheap Trick right now.
No. No. I wanted to talk to you about school.
Mm-hmm.
What was it? It was something about school.
Tom Peterson has some pretty good tones, though.
He doesn't get enough credit for that.
No, not at all.
The man invented a bass.
Basically.
Let's go! keep your eyes on the road.
Okay, good. Ease into it. You want to ease? Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa!
All my brothers proud and made for breaking. Let's start this up again. I call to march now. Hear me making. Leave this dark town far behind.
When I was in middle school, I had a band called Verböten with my friends Chris, Tracy, and Zach. And this year, the House Theater and a playwright named Brett Nevue put up a production, a musical about Verböten. And they were nice enough to include me in writing the music. And it was just one of the highlights of my life. Just an amazing, amazing cast and crew. So talented. Great storytellers, and it was successful. It got extended. Unfortunately, because of the pandemic, we couldn't do those extra 3 weeks, but we did get the first 6 weeks in. And I'm gonna play some songs now from the show, but also I wanna let you know that through May 4th, you can watch Verboten online. The House Theater in Chicago is making it available just until May 4th. And so check out their website and watch if you would like to.
Oh,
So that was the first song in Verboten, the song called New Song. I wrote that for the Jason character. The original lyrics were just the first verse three times in a row. And leading up to opening night, the director, Nathan Allen, encouraged me to go deeper with the character and write a second and third verse, which is what that was. That's the only time I've sung that song that you just saw. So the cast and the crew were set for opening night, and once that happened, we were very fortunate to get great reviews. And at that point, I decided to step back and let the cast have the spotlight. And I kind of just kept my space and didn't go to the theater very often.
Hey, welcome to Verboten. Thank you so much for coming. I'm Jason. I rarely come to these performances.
He comes to every performance.
It's crazy. I actually have a Sharpie with me. If you want anything signed.
Jenny.
Did he bring the shirt?
I'm Kieran. I just play Jason.
No, but I know, but
you have Jason.
Somebody's Jason. Okay. Okay. Totally. Okay.
During the process of writing Verboten, Brett would write a scene and then come to me and say, I need these characters to sing a song at this point. And sometimes it would be very simple and straightforward. Like, I remember at one point I said, so what needs to happen here? And he said, well, the Jason character needs a song where he basically is fighting for control of his life. So I wrote a song, I brought it to Brett, and Brett said, what's this song called? And I said, Control. But for the Brenda song, the older sister of Chris, for her song, there wasn't a lot to work with, and so I sort of wrote a backstory for her that's pretty dark, and that's this song. It's called I Can't Count on Love, written from the female perspective of the Brenda character.
Shattered past possibilities, can't find a reason. He was my one, he was my everything. Can't find a reason. Thank you.
It's been very interesting to me to see the variations of masks that people are wearing and making and providing for others. And so I thought we'd start a new segment here at the home show called Story Behind the Mask. Story Behind the Mask. And I'm very excited to welcome our first guest, Rick Nielsen. Hello, Rick.
And what do you want this time? Oh, hi, Jason.
Thank you for being here.
Good to be here.
Rick, I don't know if I've ever told you this, but when I was 10 years old...
Is this the Granada Theater story?
My dad took me to see Cheap Trick.
Oh, no.
It was in February. I remember we walked through about 2 miles of snow to get to the show. The opening band was... Off-Broadway. Stay in time, boy, don't get out of line, boy. It was at the Granada Theater, and you
yes,
guys
it's the Granada Theater story.
Put on an amazing show. You encored with Highway to Hell by AC/DC. Man, amazing show. So, I wasn't sure if I told you that story before, but could you tell us about your mask, please?
Okay, here we go. Stay in, stay healthy, and look good. This is made for me by my tailor, Tony the Tailor, Rockford, Illinois. Stay in, stay safe.
Stay in, stay safe. Absolutely. Thank you, Rick. Great to hear from you.
You too, Jason. Bye.
For the second split single record, Metal Frames, I really wanted that record to be a little bit more rocking than Fragmented World. So I opened up the record with a
a song called Glori, which is more of a kind of a Neil Young dirge, kind of a romp. And on the album, Tim Remus sings it with me. He does the higher harmony. He's got such a great voice. And then occasionally when I do solo shows, my wife will join me and sing this one, Glori. So we decided to try to record it in the basement, and we did it facing each other, and we just couldn't stop laughing. We just could not record the song because we just kept on laughing. But eventually we came up with a game plan that I would look to the right of her and she would just close her eyes so we could get through the whole song. So here's Glori. I asked my kids if they would play a Buzzcocks song with me, Why Can't I Touch It, which is the same tempo as a song by Low called Breaker. So I sampled the Low beat and we played Why Can't I Touch It over the Low loop. I hope Low doesn't mind. Alan, Mimi, thank you.
Seems so real, I can't taste it. seems so real. I can't hear it. So
punk rock Partridge Family.